Then they have, they also have Mike's 2X.
As I do that all the time.
Slash fifth man. And they will be having their starting goalie and BHL Hall of Famer, or future Hall of Famer.
Hello, BHL stream!
BHL. So, for everybody that missed it, Bandit's starting lineup will be Ardoggy Olov, Caspit Arax, and then Vasilevsky in net. The Grizzlies. Their team is not here right now, but I think it's going to be...
Give it a minute.
I'm assuming it's going to be Yuppie, Nips, and Ghosty Ferret Jaden.
How the hell?
With Aravik in net.
Is Top Ridges on the Grizzlies?
He is,
unfortunately.
Yeah. He's not playing, though, so...
That is unfortunate.
I don't think he's playing. Yeah, Yuppie just said, we'll see. But... Yuffie does have his line set with Jaden Nips, some combination of Jaden Nips, Ghosty Ferret, and himself. With
I'm gonna guess Jaden plays with Yuffie.
Maybe. I'm not sure.
No, no.
Jaden does have more of a forwards play style, but he can
well,
do
Yuffie
both.
Yuffie can play both.
He only plays D. He can play forward.
Streets have told me that Yuppie and Ghosty Ferret are playing forward this season.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Well, regardless...
wherever Yuppie goes, as long as whoever he's playing with rotates around him,
yeah,
then he's it doesn't really make a difference.
As long as you guys rotate, as long as two people rotate, BHL's not really a positional game.
Yeah. It's more just a matter of who takes the face.
Yeah, pretty much.
And let's just mean that I don't play defense.
Okay, it's BHL game
BHL
time.
BHL time, guys.
I'm killing myself.
Alright. Face-off underway. It will be Yuppie and Nips on the first line. Quake TFA is benched for this game after doing horrendously in scrims.
Yeah. Yeah.
Her Yuppie. It appears Jaden is... Oh, okay. Never mind. He was fanned, but now he's on the bench. Ghosty Ferret, nowhere to be seen. Ardoggy wins the face-off.
And my puck is broken. Or not the puck. Camera angle is broken.
Yep, I will reset it.
Auto-panning.
Nips in the corner.
Better hurry up on that.
Let me touch again. Reset broadcast.
There we don't go. Oh, there we go.
Yuppie.
Whoever is in front of the camera,
around,
go away.
Out of his own zone. Trying to fight through two bandits. Unable to as he's being pushed back. Nips there to hold the line. Nips denied by Olov at the blue line. Ardoggy will try to take it from him, but Nips fights off. Fights him off. Yuppie tries to pull it. Ardoggy pulls it through him, but oh my god, I need to fucking get my shit together. Nips at center ice, one on one with Ardoggy. Nips will win that one on one. Takes it back into his own corner. Looking to pass it up for Yuppie. Yuppie has room. Tries to get around Olov, but whiffs on it. Caspit unable to clear the zone, but Olov does after it's sent out. Why is the camera breaking? What the fuck? Yuppie.
Just auto-pan if you need to.
Yeah, I'm just gonna manually.
Put it in cinematic mode, though, if you can.
Well, I mean, I'm not streaming, it's Nick, but I'm just using the camera to commentate. Oh, Ghosty Ferret has a chance! Shoot! And Vasilevsky makes the save. Arax, in his own corner, clears it out to the center ice. Nobody there. Cast it and Ghosty Ferret will race for it. Ghosty Ferret wins. Tries the P3, but it's denied by Arax. Arax sending it up the boards for Caspit. He'll knock it into the Grizzly zone, but that's quickly recovered by Ghosty Ferret. Ghosty Ferret trying to get through Caspit, but he knocks it back to his partner, Arax. He will send it up for him. A quick P3 saved by Aravik. Keeping him on his toes there. Another P3 from Arax. Doesn't make it to the net. Hang into the corner by Aravik. Arax looking for Ardoggy. Sorry, line change that screwed me up. Pass doesn't connect. Ghosty Ferret brings it in. Arax up the boards. Our doggy now with it. Jaden steals. He'll P3 it up for Ghosty Ferret. Olav LCs to defend Ghosty Ferret. Ghosty gets past him, but unable to get a shot off. Ghosty Ferret. Outmatched by Olav. Hang the Yuppie at center ice. Yuppie drags it back. P3 way wide. Vasilevsky pings it for our doggy. He'll clear the zone, but both Grizzlies on the puck. Little miscommunication results in our doggy having a chance. He's going to try and send it up for Olav, but Yuppie just hounding him. Yuppie along the boards. Our doggy can't stop him. Olav can, though. He's sending it out of play, I guess. Damn.
First whistle. 1:37 remaining in the first.
Very high-flying action here, despite there only being two shots registered.
And this is a game team is with lots
pretty
of
much
players
what we thought
skate.
We'd see. So, oh, our doggy wins the face-off. Good move there, but Nips makes the read. Olav examining his options. He'll send it up for our doggy, who P3s it against the glass into the Grizzly zone, easily taken back by Yuppie. Yuppie gets past our doggy. Defensive error there. Olav able to outping him, though. Nips is back with the puck. In his own zone. Gets it through our doggy, but no target on that pass. Olav up the boards. Nips there to retrieve the puck. Caspit forces the puck into the Grizzly zone. He's in the slot. Tries to curve, but couldn't make the second connection. Yuppie and Nips now both chasing the puck. A too many men penalty will be assessed to the Grizzlies. It's a game of inches, I guess. It's a game of inches. Serve the too many men penalty for Boston. Caspin and Arax will run the power play unit for the Bandits. Face-off won by Ghosty Ferret. He'll immediately take it behind the net. Trying to outmaneuver Caspin, but struggling to hit the puck. Caspin's able to steal it back. Pass to Arax in the middle of the ice. Can't make the shot. Pass back to Caspit. He misses the net. Caspit up for Arax. He'll have a wide open shot. Hits the post. Aravik able to make the recovery. Pings it out. Ghosty Ferret dragging it back into neutral ice, and that will kill the penalty. Ghosty Ferret almost able to get a shorthanded shot off. His partner Yuppie back on the ice. 3 seconds to go. Doesn't look like we'll see a shot here. And that'll be the end of period one. Shots are 2-1 in favor of Houston, and we are still scoreless.
Let me know if our team stays good.
All right. So far, this game has looked very even in terms of possession. Let me just see the next the most touches. Touches are in favor of Boston, 56% to 44%. So Boston has been more dominant, but that power play did boost Houston's shot count a little. But other than that, it's been a dead even fight between these two top teams.
BHO.
Yup. That's so facts. Alright, face-off will be underway shortly in about 20 seconds. I'm not sure if people are skipping or not.
No,
I don't think they are. Yeah, they're in no rush.
Clearly that's a mute for Goose.
Nah. He's the goat. Face off underway, second period. Starting here. Yuppie. Can't get past Caspit. He's taking it. Okay, Caspit into the Grizzly zone. Fought off by Nips. Nips able to get possession behind his own net. Caspit will forecheck as Nips bobbles the puck a little. Olav waiting way outside the defensive zone, rightfully so, as Yuppie steals it from Caspit. And Olav will clamp him. Olav, sharp angle shot saved by Aravik. Olav right out to the center, or the left dot. Nobody there though. Yuppie with room, he has a breakaway, hits the post and scores! Yuppie takes advantage of Chokington's position, and he will put this game within the Grizzlies' clutches, I guess. I don't know.
Those are purple sauce. You're amazing. First goal of season 19 is to UP. That would be an interesting media article, like a first goal of every season.
Maybe. UP. Can't get it through Olav. Trying to drag it back on Ardog, but he makes the read. Nips back for it. Nips chasing it. Olav outclasses him. We'll fight for it at neutral ice, and Yuppie will knock it back into the bandit zone. Ardoggy up the boards. Trying to maintain possession, but can't. Yuppie unable to get past Olav, who's been a defensive clamp this game. Right as I say that, Ardoggy gives it away. Tough save, but a good one from Chokington. Or Vasilevsky, as his Minecraft username suggests. Back into the Grizzlies zone is Yuppie. Hanged by Ardoggy. Ardoggy can't make anything happen as he does not have an offensive partner in the zone. Caspit brings it back into the Houston zone. Jaden watching him closely. He'll pass it over for Arax, who gets past Ghosty Ferret. He'll take the P3, blocked by Jaden. That was going right to the far side. Jaden sends it behind the net, but does not pursue. That allows Arax to get it. Arax up for Caspit, a dangerous play there, knocked away by Jaden. Jaden down the ice now. Caspit retrieves the puck, over for Arax. He'll pass it right back. Caspit has room, taken away by Ghosty Ferret, though, who catches up to him in the race for the puck. Arax trying to curve. Can't get through Ghosty Ferret. He'll send it back for Jaden. Pass back for Ghosty Ferret. He has room. Shoots. Save Chokington. He'll glove the rebound. Halfway through the second period here. Faceoff in the Houston defensive zone. Caspit will win it and send it out. Jaden back with it. Sends it through Caspit. Ghosty Ferret has room. Sends it short side, and that'll be another glove for Vasilevsky. Konechny says, Ghosty Ferret score, and I Uber Eats you a Big Mac with large free weed.
I forgot how to spell the word.
Caspit spam pinging the faceoff. He'll win it. Ghosty Ferret takes it right back, though. Looks to go around, but Arax easily reads that. One-on-one with Jaden now. Arax cuts to the middle, tries to get around Aravik, who slides into place to make the save. Ardoggy cuts through Ghosty Ferret. Back for Olav. Back for Ardoggy. Tries to get the P3 away, but can't. Ghosty Ferret. going around the net, gets right through R-Doggy, loses the puck at the blue line. R-Doggy sends it right back in. Jaden, around the net, pursuing, trying to evade R-Doggy's forecheck. He can't, as R-Doggy left shifts in front of him. Yuppie on the ice now, pursues R-Doggy. He's able to bring it behind the net, wait for a change for Nips. Yuppie, still with it. Kind of at a standstill here. Yuppie behind the net. Finally gets past R-Doggy and breaks through the blue line. Sends it up. Olav wins the race to the pucks. And Olav will be clamped by Nips. Nips tries the curve. Hang by Olav into the neutral zone. Olav, no match for Yuppie. Almost gets the shot away, but Chokington able to ping it back to Olav. Yuppie trying to stuff it in the short side. Doesn't work. Olav able to take it back. Nips playing really deep on defense. Sends it up for Yuppie, but Caspit's able to catch that one. Caspit gets through Nips. Almost gets a shot away. Ervik with the ping, though. Yuppie has room, but it's taken away by Caspit. Caspit chasing Yuppie down the other way. Caspit around the net. Almost able to send it up for Arax, but Yuppie steals. Arax sends it back. Yuppie a long bong for Ghosty Ferret. Ghosty Ferret shoots. Clamped by Arax, and that'll end the period with a great shot block for the Bandits. I think the Bandits' offense is kind of stalling in the second period. They're playing a more P3-oriented style.
They do have a couple veterans on their team.
Yeah. Nips sending it out for Yuppie.
The newest one with that in that group.
Fix the camera, Vorpal.
Oh, damn, you said broadcast. There you go. Yuppie in the Houston zone.
Thank you.
Olav double teaming him with R-Dog.
Never mind, it broke.
Send a shot close to the net, but doesn't register as a shot. Olav, no match for Yuppie as he'll send it out. R-Doggy will bring it right back in. R-Doggy. One-on-one with Yuppie. They'll win that matchup. Send it up for Olav. A banger to tie this game.
He is proving he is worth the 9K bag.
I will say he has surprised me with this game.
He's been putting in the work.
He has been putting in the work. He's looking to get back to that S13 form.
Yes.
I am too, don't worry.
True. Olav. Pass up for R-Doggy. Take the long P3. Ervik coming out to make the save. Yuppie streaking down the center of the ice. Fumbles it and loses it to Olav. Nips sends it back for Yuppie. Yuppie has room, cuts to the center, gets around, it hits the post. And it's gloved down by Vasilevsky. Not sure if he saved that or if he was able to glove it after the shot, but either way, a great play to save the tie game.
There's a good vision by Yuppie there, but he just rings it off the post, it gets poked away, and Chokin can grab
true.
It.
They gave him a lot of room there. Ghosty Ferret bringing it around the net. He had Jaden open, but elected not to pass it. Caspit in the corner. They'll hit the rock. Ghosty Ferret almost curves it straight into the short side, but
I think it might have been
a little wide. Oh, Ghosty Ferret, what a move! What a goal! Ghosty Ferret gives Boston the lead 2-1. He's hungry. He's back.
for the Big Mac.
Or was this in the finals? My gosh.
He did. Last season's finals, right?
Last season's finals.
I remember Highlanders finals. We had a He's Hungry joke. Caspit sending it back for Arax. Caspit, a long P3 pang by Aravik. Game saving snag.
I'm not gonna lie, I think it was going off the post, but yeah.
No, it registered in shot, so it was definitely.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Yeah, from my angle,
it did look like it was going off the post, though, from bird's eye view.
Either way, it would have hit. If it did, it would have hit.
What a ping. Caspit wins the faceoff. Dangerous play there for Aravik, but he knocks it away. Ghosty Ferret, one-on-one with Arax. Sends it to the far side. Beats him there. Ghosty Ferret, a long P3. Wide. Arax, up for Caspit. One-on-one with Jaden. Caspit pauses in the ice. That allows Ghosty Ferret to pickpocket him. Arax, no match.
Yeah.
Ghosty Ferret curves it around. Pulls the Yuppie turn to no avail. Ardoggy and Arax. Vasilevsky will try to send it up for Ardoggy, but Yuppie is there to make the read. Yuppie. Hang out by Ardoggy, but he's back in his own zone. Still with possession is Yuppie. Trying to get past Olav. Fighting through both Bandits players right now. Yuppie. Hang out of the zone by Olav. Back in. And he'll keep it. Possession in Olav's hands. He'll send it behind the net. Yuppie pressures. He's looking to generate something. Tries the curve, but no avail and sent out of the zone. Olav. Over for Ardoggy, the long P3. Saved by Aravik. Light work for him. Yuppie. Trying to cut around. Nips now. Nips through Olav. Relatively easy save for Chokington. Sends it back, and Yuppie grabs the puck. Now it's back for Olav. He'll send it up. Pass inaccurate. Into the hands of Yuppie, but Olav regains it. Ardoggy almost has a shot. Nips able to shut that chance down, though. Nips, a shot save. Vasilevsky. The dying minutes of the third period. 1 minute left. Olav, a shot on Aravik, save. Yuppie in the corner. Behind his own net. He's looking to go short side. He gets through Ardoggy. Shot. Vasilevsky, the save. Ghosty Ferret has a wide open shot, but a weak one at that. Ardoggy. Looking to make something happen in the corner. Stutters a little. Caspit back with it. Neither of the Bandits can seem to hit the puck. Ardoggy on very little stam. Just crawling off the ice.
Butterfingers right now.
Arax. 20 seconds left for the Bandits. Can they make something happen? Caspit pings Ghosty Ferret. Looking for the P3. Ghosty Ferret. He took too long with that one, and Ghosty Ferret gets the easy block. 10 seconds. Ghosty Ferret, a P3. Back into the Bandits' corner. 7 seconds left. Arax will have to cut through Yuppie. He does. Arax. Hang out by Ghosty Ferret. And the Grizzlies will hang on to win this game. 2-1. Great performance on both sides. But Aravik ultimately shuts it down. Apparently the boards are fucked, according to Arax, which is just not true.
I know what he means. He means the benches, around the benches, cause the bench boards act differently. We'll bring Yuppie up for
interview. Yuppie interview.
Oh, Eggs has just disappeared.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello, Mr. Blocky Hockey himself.
Mr. Blocky Hockey.
It's going awesome.
Mr. Really BHL. Well.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, that's me.
That's the guy.
So what's interview questions?
I'm supposed to ask those.
Who on your team do you think had the biggest standout performance besides yourself?
Hello, BHL.
Hey,
hey,
get this guy. Get this guy out of here.
Get out. I am actually really, really happy with Ghosty Ferret and Erevic tonight. I think they played really well. I think our D-men also performed, but they still have a lot of work to do. And I think once we round out their games, we're gonna be unstoppable.
I agree. Here, let's bring Ghosty Ferret up here for a double interview, and then we can interview Olav and Vasilevsky.
Hello.
Without bringing themselves in.
Hello, Mr. BHL 2.
Oh, thanks.
He is not Mr. BHL 2. This guy is...
I appreciate the compliment, but don't think...
This guy is Mr. Fat Ass 2. Sorry.
All right.
Whoa.
I'm sorry. Okay. I apologize.
Hey. Ghosty Ferret, how do you think... what improvements do you think you've made to your game this offseason that showed this game?
The mental, yeah, the mental went up.
You got the aura. He's got the aura now.
I think my mechanics are as good as they have been ever, but I think my mental is really what improved this off season. So, and like knowledge of the game, obviously.
True.
That's good, Ghosty Ferret.
Connect me. You got any questions? I'm kind of struggling.
Hang on, let me think.
Christ.
I forgot to think. Dude, you're asking like Damoni and then me for questions here. Do you think? Do you think Ferret will be able to continue scoring throughout the entire season?
Yeah, I think it's only going to go up from here. I think he performed well against one of the better second lines, and I think that almost every team in the league, he's going to be able to do even better.
Dude, do you see this guy at the center ice? Like, I'm sorry. Do you see that he is circling the center ice fucking dot? Yeah, go back doing that. Ferret, look at him.
I'll go back to it.
Ghosty Ferret, like, it's like his post-game...
Trying to lose some of the weight.
It's his workout.
It's his post-game cooldown.
Yeah.
Ferret reminds me a lot about
a light jog around the ice.
Ferret reminds me a lot about Phil Kessel, just without the playoff performance.
Hey, he's had a playoff performance.
Okay, I have a question. I have a question that I definitely am not stealing from Akuzo. Do you guys think the Freedom will be an easier team to play against than the Bandits?
We're not going to underestimate them, obviously.
Does the audience have a question?
That is a kind of cliche answer, but. I think the Bandits were a tough team. I think they had a good matchup for us. We did get the advantage of scrimming them in the preseason, so we kind of were able to adjust based off those games. But I think the Freedom are going to be a good test for us when we do get to those games. Yeah, obviously, the rematch from finals. So we're excited for that. But
basically.
I do think they will be more difficult than Bandits, just purely on a matchup standpoint.
How many games do you think the Cup Finals will go to with the San Antonio Rage?
They're going to sweep three.
Easy.
So true.
Curtis the dog
is securing MVP.
Curtis the dog will be proving himself as the best player
to
ever
grace
this planet.
Hockey, but he is Mr. BHL himself.
He is the father of BHL. Oh, he is the father of BHL. All right, I think the Bandits want to do their interview. All right, so
we need to run Bandits interview before the next game.
All right, hello, BHL.
Oh, it's Mr. BHL 2 himself, Mr. Former Vice Commish.
Hello, both of us. What do you mean?
Mr. Former's Vice Commissioners.
Thank you.
How are you guys happy with how your team played?
Absolutely.
That's good.
I'm not gonna lie. I thought it was gonna be a lot more higher scoring.
I also
purely based off of the players in the match. But both teams played very well defensively. And there's not much I can really speak on that. We all played well.
Yeah, we just had a blunder of letting Ghosty Ferret score. Like, who does that?
We made a couple key defensive errors. lost us the game.
That is correct. Over.
Okay.
Okay, train conductor.
I noticed you guys are pretty heavy on the P3s. Is that intentional? Do you mean to do that, like, with your offensive playstyle, or...
I mean...
Is that just instinctual?
Our head coach, our strat coach or whatever, he's been cooking something up, so... Just trying to play to that.
True, Yasmin.
Okay, I have a question.
Yeah.
What went wrong this game?
Bad pinch by me. Actually, bad fucking play on the boards by me on Yuppie. And then Ghost Fair just had an insane move out of the corner, honestly. We knew it was in his bag, but we didn't actually, like...
Didn't expect it in his bag, you know?
Okay, and I guess...
He does it every so often.
Okay, and then I guess last question for me. Are you guys, like, considering changing anything up? Are you going to just run this the next game and hope it works?
Absolutely not.
Yeah, we're going to run it the next
game. That makes
sense. You know, hopefully an easier opponent than the Boston Grizzlies. You know, they have two, you know, Mr. BHL and Mr. BHL 2 or whatever you guys are calling them.
Mr. BHL exactly. 2 and the food guy. So.
The food guy is crazy.
Mr. BHL 2 oh, and the food guy.
All right.
Mr. BHL is already taken by Curtis the dog.
All right. Sorry. Well, I think that is all for this stream. We got the next game. We'll be back in like 2 minutes. So I don't know who's playing. I think it's Orlando and Freedom.
Yep.
Yeah,
so we'll see you there.